Hello everyone, now we are going to discuss about causes, impacts including social, economic, political, environmental, health and psychological. Unit 1, Introduction to Disaster. The subject name is Disaster Management. This unit objective is to provide student an exposure to disaster, their significance and types. This unit outcome is we will able to differentiate the type of disaster, causes and their impact on environment and society. The first one is physical impact of disaster. Every year, millions of people are affected by both human caused and natural disasters. Disaster may be explosion, earthquake, floods, hurricane, tornado or fires. In a disaster, we face the danger of death or physical injury. We may also lose our homes and community. Such stressors place we at risk for emotional and physical health problems. Stress reaction after a disaster look very much like the common reaction seen after any type of people. Disaster can cause a full range of mental and physical reactions. So here the main important physical impacts of disaster: injury, death, physical disability, burn, epidemic, weakness, uneasiness, physical illness, sanitation, miscarriage, reproductive health, fatigue, loss of sleep, loss of appetite. The next, economic impact of disaster. So major natural disaster can and do have severe negative short-term economic impact. Disasters also appear to have adverse long-term consequences for economic growth, development and poverty reduction. But negative impact are not inevitable. Vulnerability is shifting quickly, especially in all countries expecting economic transformation, rapid growth, urbanization and related technique and social changes. So here the economic impacts are loss of life, unemployment, loss of livelihood, loss of property and land, loss of household article, loss of crops, loss of public infrastructures. So next one is social impact of disaster. So here economic and social development throughout the world is frequently interrupted by extreme event. Although disaster event impact both developed and developing countries, they can cause a sharp increase in poverty. It is important to assess their global, regional, economic and social impact. So here, change in individual's role, disrupt of social fabric, isolation, change in marital status, sexual abuse and domestic violence, orphans, single parent children, family and social disorganization, migration, lifestyle changes, breakdown of traditional social status. So the next one is physical impact of disaster. Disaster and mental health are related to a large extent. The effect of disaster might have a negative impact on the affected people. Along with the social and economic losses, the individuals and communities experience a mental instability which might precipitate post-traumatic stress disorder, that's called PTSD, and depression in the population. Generally, the disaster are measured by the cost of social and economic damage, but there is no expansion to the emotional suffering a person undergoes post-disaster. So here, distress, flashbacks, intrusion, avoidance, haters, revenge, dependence, insecurity, grief, withdrawn, isolation, guilt feeling, hyper vigilance, lack of stress, helplessness, hopelessness. So here more vulnerable groups: children, pregnant women, elder people, and people who are ill or immunocompromised are particularly vulnerable when a disaster strikes and take a relatively high share of the disease burden associated with emergencies. Poverty and its common consequences, such as malnutrition, homelessness, poor housing, and decision, is a major contribution to vulnerability. So here we listed includes more vulnerable group people are women, children, old aged, physical and mentally challenged, and people with critical needs. So different impact of women: deterioration of health, that's called lack of food and nutrient, restricted mobility prevents from taking early warning and evacuation, greater stress, and perceived to be victims rather than responders. The next one is impact on children. So health: undernourishment, malnutrient, inadequate hygienic and sanitation, children are there. Psychological: fear, anxiety, childish or regressive behavior, difficulty in sleeping and concentrating. And education wise: studies discontinued, schools being used as shelter, girl children dropped out. So next one is impact in mother and child: increased cases of complication and premature delivery amongst women feeding off infant, children born or weak, and stress interferes with the release of milk in mothers and it weakens the immune system of child. Children born as a consequences of gender-based violence is most important. Next one is aged population: natural aging process, impaired balance, that mean balance disorder, decreased strength, poor exercise tolerance, deterioration of sight, hearing, smell, taste and touch is the most impact of aged population. And also for the impact on aged population is unable to hear danger signals, alarm, etc., difficulty in evacuation, difficulty in protection, difficulty in getting access to relief and compensation money, and also difficulty to locating avenues of escape, have to face the shock of losing all that they had attained in life, home, family, security. The next one is physical and mentally challenged impact. Disability is not just a health problem or attribute in individuals, but it reflects the problems individuals experiencing in their interaction with society and physical movement. Disabled person remaining neglected part of society, and they also experience various barriers due to restriction of participant. So the peoples are visually challenged, hearing impaired, physically disabled, mentally challenged. The people with critical needs, dependent on life-sustaining medication such as with HIV, AIDS, on dialysis, epileptic, diabetes, or depending on medication to control condition and maintain quality of life such as pain and control medicines, etc. Dependency upon health care facilities and health care professionals. In disasters, pre-existing medical condition inability to function and or aggravated by loss of meds, loss of health care venues like hospital, dialysis center and medicals. The conclusion, what needs to be done? Establish mechanism to support the more vulnerable group to access their entitlement and create opportunities for them to participate in decision making. So, thank you everyone.